Macros are a great tool while you are working in a document, particularly when you have to perform various repetitive tasks. So instead of you doing one thing over and over and over again through all the different steps, what you can do is you can record all of those steps in a macro and then you simply execute that macro. So here's how it works. To get to the macros, all that we have to do is we go under the View tab in Word, and then we go under the Macros option here. Then we click on Record Macro. In this case, I'm going to record bringing up labels, for example, label Avery 5160. So instead of you having to do all of those steps time after time, you simply execute the macro. So we click here on Record Macro, and then we'll give it a name. Now, it says that assign macro to, you can assign the macro to a specific button, which would be an icon here somewhere in the quick access toolbar or somewhere. So you can assign to this macro a button or a keyboard shortcut. So in this case, I'm going to assign a button. And then notice it says new macro, macro 1. You can change the name if you'd like. And then I'm going to add this. Notice it's going to be on the quick access toolbar. But I'm going to add this also to the right-hand side here. So I want to customize my quick access toolbar. So I want to click on Add, and then I'm going to click OK. All that is going to do is it put this icon over here. Now notice that at this point, next to the mouse, there's this little cassette tape. That means that every step or every click that I perform from this point on until I stop it, all of those steps are going to be recorded. So now, to insert a label, usually you'd go under Mailings, and then you'll go under Labels. Once you go under Labels, we need to go here under Options, and then we'll pick the specific type of label that we want. We said earlier that we wanted Avery 5160. So we go here under Label Vendors, and we'll want to change this to Avery. So we choose Avery US Letter. And then the number here, it actually depends on the box of labels that you purchase from the store. So we want here 5160, for example. And there it is. So we click OK. And then here we click on New Document. Now notice it brought and it designed this document to be that type of label. So this is where we want our macro to stop. So at this point, all we have to do is we click here under View, we go back to Macros, and we choose Stop Recording. So now the macro has been recorded and all the steps have been recorded. Notice we have an icon here on the very top. So let's assume now another day came by and we want to create labels. So we go here under New, we choose Document, and all of a sudden we have a need for those labels for Avery 5160, and we don't have to go and search for the label, search for the vendor and all that type of stuff. So all we have to do at this point is we click on this icon here for the macro, and notice the label definition has been applied. So it's the same step for anything else that you do in a repetitious way within Word. All of those steps, you can record them exactly the same way. You can use macros to open a file from a specific location, or you can have it to create labels or put headers, footers, or whatever else that you do within Microsoft Word.